Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're going to convert recurring decimals to fractions. Okay, before we get going, a little bit of notation. Now, these decimals here are all called recurring decimals. And what I mean by that is they repeat themselves in the pattern after the decimal point. Now this one's an obvious repeated one. It just goes 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3 forever. And there's a way we write that as mathematicians. We write 0.3 with a dot above it to say the 3 is continuing forever. Mathematicians are inherently lazy. They rather write something shorthand than write the whole thing out. Now the next one repeats, hopefully you can see, it repeats its 4, 3, then it repeats its 4, 3, then it repeats its 4, 3, then it repeats its 4, 3. How do you think a mathematician would write that, given what you know in part one? Well, they would write 0.43 with a dot above the 4 and a dot above the 3. How do you think they'd write the next one? Well, what's recurring? The 5, 6, 9 is recurring, the 5, 6, 9 and the 5, 6, 9. So they'd write 0.569 and they'd put a dot above the 9 where, and a dot above the 5 where the recurring starts and where it finishes. Now the next one's actually slightly different if you think about it, because what repeats here? Well, the 1, 3, the 1, 3, the 1, 3 and the 1, 3. The 0.2 at the start isn't part of the repeating pattern. So therefore we would write 0.2, leaving that alone, and we would write 1, 3, put the dot above the 1 and the dot above the 3 to say it's only the 1, 3 that's recurring. What about the next one? Well, again, what is recurring here? Well, the 8, 3 is, the 8, 3, the 8, 3 and the 8, 3, but the 1 at the start wasn't part of that recurring. So we'd write 1 there and we'd put a decimal point down. We'd write 8, 3, put the dot above the 8 and the dot above the 3. And the last one here? Well, what's recurring here? The 2, 3 and 5 aren't part of the recurring. It's the 6, 7, 6, 7, 6, 7 that recurs. So what we'd do is we'd write 23.5. Normally, we'd write the 6 and the 7, but the dot goes above the 6 and the 7 to say it's the 6 and 7 that are repeating itself. And these are recurring decimals and the notation you need to use to be able to demonstrate them. You don't want to be writing out these big, long decimals here. Using this dot method shows you that the decimal is actually recurring, i.e. there's a pattern that ends up repeating in that decimal expansion. Now, what we're going to talk about here is we're going to convert decimals to fractions. The technique I'm going to use is a little bit of algebra, so that comes within the algebra section and you may not have seen that yet, but it's not too advanced and you just have to bear with me, but when you do your algebra it will make more sense. If you want to convert the following decimal to a fraction, what we're going to do is we're going to give it a letter name and we're going to say, imagine this thing here, we'll call it a name, let's call it X. Okay, and we write it out a few times, right? And we're going to do something really clever here, I think you're going to like this. If we multiply both sides by 10, so we have 1x and we're going to multiply by 10, and a mathematician writes that like 10x. Now what happens if we're going to multiply this decimal by 10? Well, what are we going to get? We're going to get 4.444444, and the 4s go on forever as well. Alright? Now, we can call this number 1 and this number 2. And we could do something really cool now to eliminate these 4444s. Watch what we can do. We can say, imagine you took the whole everything in line 2 and we subtracted everything in line 1. So we'd have 10 x's take away a single x. What would we be left with? Well, you'd be left with 9 x's, wouldn't you? And what would that be equal to on the other side? Well, 4.444444 take away 0.444444, because everything's aligned, it would just cancel out all the 4s. And we're just going to get 4 take away 0, which is 4. Now, if 9 x's are something, if 9 multiplied by x, 9 lots of x are 4, then using our related multiplication and division facts, x therefore must be 4 divided by 9, which we can write like that. And hence, x is 4 divided by 9. Now, x was just a name we gave this recurring decimal that we wanted to find out what it was as a fraction. And now we've actually shown that x is this fraction. So we have found that 4/9 as a fraction is the same thing as 0.4 recurring. All right? Do you feel ready to try exactly the same method on 0.5 recurring and see what you get? Pause the video and have a go. Okay, I'm just going to go through it. I would say x is 0.55555555. I would multiply both sides by 10 so that 10x was 5.55555555, because what we want to do is call that 1 and call that 2, and we're going to take the whole of 2 and subtract all of 1 from it. 10x subtract 1x is 9x, and this is perfectly worked out. 5 point with all the 5s recurring, take away 0 point with all the 5s recurring. Well, what that does, all it's going to do is eliminate all these 0.555s recurring, and we're going to be left with 5. If 9 lots of x are 5, x must be 5 over 9 or 5/9. So 0.5 recurring is the same thing as 5/9. Now, can you spot a pattern? 0.4 recurring was 4/9. 0.5 recurring is 5/9. So what would this be? Straight away, 0.4 recurring is always whatever the number is recurring, 4 over 9. 0.7 recurring, whatever that number is there, is going to be 7 over 9. And 0.1 recurring is going to be whatever that number is there, 1 over 9. And you can check this on a calculator. Dividing by 9 is very special, and it always works out. Watch, 4 divided by 9 equals, press the SD button, all the 4s. 7 divided by 9 equals, press the SD button, all the 7s. The only reason that says 8 is the calculator is trying to do a round at the end, okay? But if it left it go forever, it would be all 7s. And 1 divided by 9, okay? So what would 2 divided by 9 be? Well, it would be 0.22222. Let's double check. All the 2s. There you go. Okay, so knowing what we know about when it's 0.333 recurring, etc., what would these two be? Well, this would be 3/9. And we just touched on this idea on the last video. We can actually simplify this fraction. So look in the fraction section for much more detail on this. The highest common factor of 3 and 9 is 3. We can simplify this by dividing the top and bottom by 3 and actually saying that's 1/3. And similarly here, this thing here is going to originally be 6/9, but the highest common factor of 6 and 9 is 3, and we could divide the top and bottom by 3 and we would get the answer that this is actually 2/3. So we've learnt something special about dividing by 9. Let's try another example, nothing to do with 9. Let's try and convert this decimal to a fraction in the same way we did with when we were dividing by 9. Let's give it a go. Firstly, call it x. Now, if we multiply both sides by x, we get 10x is equal to 2.32323232323232. Now, if I call this 1 and this 2, and I subtract them from each other, can you see that the decimals aren't perfectly lined up? They're not going to cancel each other. That's 2323. This is 3232. They're not going to take away. So we've got to be super clever, and we've got to multiply, actually, by another 10. So we'd get 100 x's would be 23.23232323232323. And hopefully now you can see that equation 1 and what we're going to call equation 3, their decimals line up perfectly, and they'll be perfect for the subtraction to get rid of this recurring decimal. So let's do 3 subtract 1. 100x take away 1x is 99x. And 23.2323 take away 0.232323 is just 23. So if 99 lots of x are 23, 1 lot of x is 23 divided by 99. And that's it. We have worked out this fraction here. Right, I've got one more at the end of the video for you to have a go at. So have a look, pause, and try it. I'm just going to show you the answer for the last one, but hopefully you've got enough confidence to give it a go. Right, here is the answer. So working through exactly as I did before, I get x is 15 over 99. The only thing to say is, I can simplify this. I could divide the top and bottom by the highest common factor of 15 and 99, which is 3, and I would simplify it to 5 over 33. And that's it. We're done for this video. Thanks for watching.